In a withdrawal form dated 25th October, written by the Deputy IGG Patricia Achan Okiria, addressed to the Trial Magistrate and the High Court Anti-Corruption Division, the Inspectorate of Government is no longer interested in continuing with Ebiru's case. Ebiru has been facing charges of corruption after confessing of offering a bribe to Charles Masekura, the Uganda National Bureau of Standards board chairperson, between October and December 2022, as part of his efforts to retain his position as the UNBS Executive Director. During the Kosase probe into UNBS operations, Ebiru revealed that he had bribed the UNBS board chair, Charles Masekura, with 100 million shillings.
Confirming to this committee that you bribed board members with 100 million shillings.
I was asked through by the chair that I must do the needful to cool down what is going on.
And you gave them 100 million shillings?
Yes, sir.
Ebiru was also implicated by Kosase for misappropriating royalties generated from pre-export verification of conformity to standards program, PVOC, amounting to 12.5 billion shillings. It's alleged that Ebiru went to the pre-export verification of conformity to standards program collection account and withdrew 12.5 billion shillings without approval.
I wish to formally submit to withdraw that statement because I took note that it offended many people and was quoted out of context. The issue of offering my chairman 100 million for protection, as reported, I want to withdraw it formally because I know that it was recorded, but I want to confirm that it was out of the environment we're operating, high tempers, high animosity, so it was really not intended.
I was reading the body language of the ED and the chairman. It was different from the previous days, and I think that confirms what the EDC is trying to talk about.
This has been a lot of agony to some of us.
I think I had never known the usefulness of these parliamentary committees, and I will tell very many people about this.
He was also found liable by the same committee for causing UNBS a loss of 9.2 billion shillings when he failed to take appropriate action on five staff members who caused this loss to the entity.
I don't want someone to die and then say this person, the family says he died because Kosase asked hard questions.
Ebiru has been produced in court to be charged with the offense of corruption and the case was registered. But he did not appear before court as he was taken back to the office of the IGG before the court could convene and was later freed. Court later on August 8th issued a warrant of arrest against Ebiru to come and take plea after skipping several summons. But instead, Ebiru filed an application challenging his trial, which was dismissed by the anti-corruption court judge, Jane Kajuga, on September 20th, 2023, for lack of jurisdiction. It's after the twist of events that the IGG has entered a formal notice to late Ebiru, who was fired by the Minister of Trade in August, off the hook on account of lack of evidence, according to the entity's spokesperson, Ali Munira. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.